need to work on our jigs, so we need to make them two. So again, we need to start with our magic ring. Into the our magic ring, we need to work 6 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we can pull our tail a little bit, and into the our first single crochet we need to work 2 single crochets. And then in every one stitch we need to work 2 single crochets. So actually at the end of that row again we're supposed to have 12 single crochets. For our third row we need to work 1 single crochet in first stitch, then 2 single crochets in the second. And 2, and now 1 single crochet into the next stitch and 2 single crochet into the second. So at the end of that row we supposed to have 18 stitches. And into the next 2, 1, and then into the next 2. Row number 4. Into row number 4 we need to work single crochet into the first 2 stitches. And then into our third one stitch we need to work 2 single crochets in our one stitch. And again 1 single crochet in next 2 stitches. And then 2 single crochet into the next one. So repeat that pattern all the way around and then make 1 more row with 1 single crochet all the way around. Now we need to work on our ears, so I've done my first one. So we need to start with magic ring again. Then 6 single crochets into the our ring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We can pull our tail a little bit, and then into our single crochets we need to work 2 single crochets in every one stitch. After first one I will put my marker stitch. So at the end of that row we supposed to have 12 single crochets. Into the row number 3 we need to work single crochet into the first 3 stitches. So 1, 2, and 3. And then into the fourth we need to work 2 single crochets in one stitch. And again single crochet into the next 4 stitches. into the next 3, and then into the 4th we need to work 2 single crochets. And one more time, single crochet into the next 3 stitches. And into our 4th stitch, the last one, we need to work 2 single crochets. So at the end of that row, we're supposed to have 15 stitches. And now for the next one row, we need to work 1 single crochet all the way around in every one stitch. Row number 5, into the next 4 stitches, we need to work 1 single crochet. So 1, 2, 3 and 4, and into the 5th we need to work 2 single crochets in one stitch, 1 and 2. And now we need to repeat 2 more times, 4 single crochets, 4 stitches with 1 single crochet, and then into the 5th we need to work 2 single crochet in one stitch. And then into the next one row we need to work 1 single crochet in every one stitch all the way around. So in our row number 5 and 6 we're supposed to have 18 stitches. Now row number 7, so we need to make 1 single crochet into the next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and then into the 6th we need to work 2 single crochets in one stitch. And then again 5 stitches with only 1 single crochet, and into the 6th we're supposed to make 2 single crochets in one stitch. At the end of that row we're supposed to have 21 stitches. And then when you finish that one row, we need to make next row with 1 single crochet all the way around. Row number 9, we need to work single crochet into the next 6 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and then into the 7th we need to work 2 single crochets in one stitch. And again we need to repeat that pattern all the way around, so 6 stitches with 1 single crochet, and then into the 7th we need to work 2 single crochets in one stitch. And then until row 16 we need to work 1 single crochet all the way around. So we are now into the row number 9. So for the next 6 rows we need to work 1 single crochet all the way around. When our ear is done, we need to sew the 2 sides together. So when you finish your last 16 rows, you need to make a slip stitch into the next single crochet, and then fasten off and cut your yarn. Then we need to sew our 2 sides together, as I am doing now. And when we are at the end, we need to fold our ear like that, and then we need to sew the 2 corners together. Okay, so now we can leave it for a few seconds. And now what I want to show you, we need to take our head and put our safety eyes, safety toys eyes. I put in onto our third row, so 1, 2, and 3, onto the third one row, into the center of our head we will put the nose. So now when we've got our eyes, we can put the toy stuff in inside. Okay, so at the moment, and now we can connect, we can sew to the head our ears. So I will make in the same line as our eyes. So at the moment I try to. And maybe in about 1, 2, 3, 4, between 5 and 6th row. So 5th and 6th row. Okay, and when we just started, now we can sew the one side of our ear into our head. So actually, that will be from the front, from the first row until the sixth. So where our first side is done, we need to go around and make with the second one exactly the same. We need to sew the second side of our ear to the head. The second ear I've done exactly the same, I just sew all the way around, and now we need to start working on our cheeks. So I sew the two cheeks together like that on one side, and now that one side which we sewed, we need to sew to the our head. So as I said, the center of our head, that will be space for the nose, so we need to sew it a little bit below. So like that. And now we need to sew that whole side till our head. Looks okay. And then we need to start folding that. We need to start sewing the edge of our cheek all the way around. Okay, so I turn my work upside down and now I will start sewing the edge of our cheek. Okay, so we need to do all the way around, but onto the top of our cheek, just here, we need to leave a space because we need to put inside a little bit toy stuff again. Okay, I sewed my cheek all the way around. I am nearly at the end, so I left the loop to put my toy stuff in. We need to make it big because that's the rabbit, so they've got big cheeks. A little bit more. Just a little bit. And now, when we've done it, we can sew them to the end, and again do the same with the other side, and at the end you need to leave a little bit space. For putting this toy stuff in again. And then we need to make our nose and our tail. I just finished sewing my cheeks and I just sew the small pompon as our little nose. Then you need to sew your back hole a little bit, not too tight, but as you can see, then it will be easier sew our head to the main purse, to the body. And then now we need to work on our paws. We need to make two of the front paws. I've done my first already, and then two of the back paws, and I've done my first one already. Now I will show you how we need to make the front one. We need to start making a magic ring. And then into our magic ring we need to make 6 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we can pull our tail a little bit, and then into the all 6 single crochets we need to work 2 single crochet in every one stitch. So at the end of that one row we're supposed to have 12 single crochets. And then 4, 5, and 6. When you've done your 12 single crochets, now into the round number 3, we need to make exactly the same. So 2 single crochets in every one stitch. So at the end of that row, we're supposed to have 24 single crochets. In row number 4, we need to work 1 single crochet all the way around. So at the end of that one row, we're supposed to have again 24 stitches. Row number 5, we need to make decrease into the first 2 stitches. So as I've done, we need to put our crochet hook into the stitch, then yarn over. When we've got 2 loops on our hook, we're not making the single crochets. We need to put into the next one stitch, grab the yarn, and when we've got 3 loops on our hook, then we need to pull for those 3. Our first increase is done. Now is the best way to mark our stitch. And then into the next 10 stitches, we need to make another 5 decreases. So that I've done the second. Now I will do the third. Fourth. Fifth. And the last one, 6th. And now we're supposed to have 12 stitches left, and in every one stitch we need to work 1 single crochet. So 12 single crochets and 6 time decreases. So at the end of our row number 5 we're supposed to have 18 stitches, and now we need to work 1 single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Into the first we need to put our marker stitch. So I've done first 1, 2, 1 into the next 2, 3, and into the 4th one, next one, and then into the next 2 we need to make decrease again. So we've done 4 single crochet and then decrease, and again we need to make 4 single crochet and then another decrease. And then we need to repeat that pattern one more time, 4 single crochets and 1 decrease. So at the end of that one row, row number 6, we supposed to have 15 stitches, and then into the next 3 rows we need to work 1 single crochet in every stitch around. So now I just start the row number 7, and then into the row number 8 and 9 we need to work 1 single crochet in every one stitch. For the next row number 10, we need to make exactly the same, 1 single crochet into the every one stitch all the way around, and then at the end of that one row we need to make a slip stitch into the next single crochet and then fasten off and cut our yarn. I just finished my front pouch, so we need to just put our toy stuff inside. So put just lots of inside to make our pouch firmly. And then I want to show you how to make the back pouch. We need to make exactly the same as we've done the front one until the row number 10, and then we need to add more rows. So row number 11, into the first 2 stitches we need to work 2 single crochets, in every one stitch 1 single crochet. So next 2 stitches with 1 single crochet, and then into the third one we need to work 2 single crochets in 1 stitch. And then we need to repeat. Next 2 stitches with 1 single crochet, 1 and 2, and then next 2 single crochet in 1 stitch. All the way around we need to repeat that pattern, and at the end of that row we're supposed to have 20 stitches. Into the row number 12 we need to work single crochet in the first 3 stitches. I've done 2 and then 3, and now into the our fourth 1 stitch we need to work 2 single crochets in 1 stitch, and again next 3 stitches with 1 single crochet in every 1 stitch, and then into the fourth 2 single crochets in 1 stitch, and now we need to repeat that pattern all the way around. At the end of that one row, the row number 12, we're supposed to have 25 stitches. And now again, we need to put our toy stuff in. And now into the next 3 rows, so from 13 to 15, we need to work 1 single crochet all the way around. At the row number 16, into our first 3 stitches, we need to work 1 single crochet. 1, 2 and 3, and then we need to make a decrease into the next 2 stitches, and again we need to work 3 single crochets, 1, 2 and 3, and into the fourth one we need to work 1 decrease. So we need to repeat that pattern all the way around, and at the end of that one row we're supposed to have 20 stitches in total. Now at the end of our row number 16 we need to put more our toy stuff in, but now just a little bit, not too much, And then for the next two rows, we need to work decrease all the way around. So at the end of our second row, we're supposed to have only 5 stitches. So I've done my first one, now is the second, and in that one row we're supposed to have 10 stitches, and into the next only 5. So at the end we need to make a slip stitch into the next one stitch and then fasten off and cut our yarn. So our legs I've done, you need to make two of the same from the front and from the back. Now one more thing left, we need to work on our tail. So again we need to make a magic ring, and then into the our magic ring we need to make 6 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and now we need to work in only on our back loops, no through both stitches, only into the back loops. So in every one back loop we need to work 2 single crochets. So at the end of that one row you're supposed to have 12 stitches. In row number 3 we need to work on our back loops again, and now into the first one single crochet we need to work 1 single crochet, then into the our second we need to work 2 single crochets in one stitch, and again 1 single crochet in the first one, and then 2 single crochets into the next. So at the end of that one row we're supposed to have 18 single crochets, and all around we need to work on back loop only. In row number 4 we need to work our single crochet for the first 2 stitches, and then into the third one we need to work 2 single crochet in one stitch, and again we need to work into the back loop only. Whole rows at the moment we are working on the back loops only, and then again 2 stitches with 1 single crochet, and then into the third one we need to work 2. So repeat that pattern all the way around, and then into the next one row we need to work 1 single crochet all the way around, and again onto the back loop only. Into the next 2 rows we need to work decrease on all the way around. So at the end of our second row we're supposed to have only 6 stitches, and after that one row we need to put some toy stuff in already, because then we will have a small loop. So before you will do the last one row, just put toy stuff in and then finish your work. At the end of your second row just make a slip stitch into the next one stitch, and then fasten off and cut our yarn. When we've got all of our parts done, we need to start sewing everything together. So we need to start with our head. Just put your head next to the one of the corner of our purse, and then sew them together. Try to sew the head all the way around, and then we will start sewing our paws and the tail as well. Okay, my back is already done. I sew all my parts together, so you need to sew your front paws and the back paws and the tail as well. So your tail you need to sew exactly into the center of our second corner, just onto the second row from the top. Then sew your back paws just at the end of your main purse, and then your small front pose just next to your head, and then I add one piece of ribbon, and that's it, and our work is done. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe.